وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Learn Islam, live Islam, love Islam, look at Islam. Inshallah, he is our speaker for today to follow the steps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in learning, understanding, applying, and passing the message. Muhammad Jahangir, 11th graders, he is listening.
الحمد لله وكفى والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. عن ابي هريره رضي الله عنه ان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مر به وهو يغرس غرسا فقال يا ابا هريره ماذا تغرس؟ قلت غرسا لي. قال الا ادلك على غرس خير لك من هذا؟ قال بلى يا رسول الله. قال قل سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا اله الا الله والله اكبر. يغرس لك بكل واحده شجره في الجنه. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once he was passing by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, while he was planting a sapling, a seed into the ground. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Abu Huraira, "Oh Abu Huraira, what are you doing?" He said, "I'm planting a sapling, I'm planting a seed." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Oh Abu Huraira, should I not tell you about a seed, a sapling, which is better than what you're doing?" He said, "Yes, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Say Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah and La ilaha illallah and Allahu Akbar. With each of these four words, a tree will be planted for you in Jannah." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many ahadith, he gives us different ways of thinking. Like he gave Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu a different way of thinking. What's a real seed? What's a real sapling? In one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man salaka tariqan yaqlubu fiha ilman sahhalallahu lahu tariqan ila al-jannah." Whoever seeks a path in order to gain knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the path to Jannah easy for them. And in another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Laysa shadidu," the meaning of the hadith is, the strong person is not he who has physical strength, but it is he who can control himself when he is angry. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is changing how we look at the world, how we look at the dunya, how we prioritize ourselves in the dunya. Previously it was mentioned by Shaykh Hasan, he mentioned the virtues of dhikr. So I found it appropriate. I found what Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawzi rahimahullah mentions in one of his books, Al-Wabil Sayyid. He mentions the virtues of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he counts them to be more than 100. And I will state a few of them. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says, and these are all conclusion derived on based on hadith. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says that dhikr relieves the mind of anxieties and worries. This dunya we have, in the akhirah there will be no worries, but we have so many worries in this dunya, we can use dhikr to make our dunya like Jannah with no worries. It removes anxieties and worries. Dhikr brightens the face and the heart of the person who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr attracts one's sustenance. Many times we worry for our sustenance. How will we get the rizq? When we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we attract dhikr to come to us. He also mentions, rahimahullah, that if one remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in happiness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember him in difficult times. He mentions the key to nearness. Dhikr is the key to nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the closer you are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the less you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the farther away you are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And lastly, one of the things which he mentioned is that dhikr gives life to the heart. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said that dhikr for the heart is the same as water is to fish. How can a fish survive without water? So our heart is the same thing. We need dhikr just like a fish needs water. We need it. It's one of our needs more than food and water. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the tawfiq to implement what he has said in prayer.
Jazakallahu khayran, Muhammad. You know, alhamdulillah, as we mentioned before, this is the strategy, is to get the students at early age. We're starting with high school, and we go with lower grades, we're doing the sibling and everything. We get them to get the feeling of putting what they learn in practice. Many of us memorize so many ahadith, so many ayat, that they cannot put two words together. I'm talking elders, not kids. Put two words together when they need to, or at time of need where someone might criticize, or someone might ask a question you don't know how to go. So we're building that confidence in the students to talk and to understand and to apply. Learn, live, and love. And if you love, you have to talk. And if you don't talk, that means you don't love. And if you do love, that means it's faith. Alhamdulillah, this is, it's going wonderful. And before you run after people, you convince. Now I see students coming. They want to do it and win. In fact, some of the complaints I have, Sheikh, one time a week, it's not enough. I mean, it's like I have to wait my turn for so long before I can get there and speak again. And we're inventing other ways to do it in the class, and to do it after the salah, and to do it in different situations. This week, inshallah, the fruit of this work will surface even more and farther. One of the 11 great students, inshallah, is going to give a real khutbah in Center Masjid, Arlington. And check this out, and a fundraising after that. That's what we do with ISI. We fundraise. Right, brother? Dhikr, connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what we do. We connect you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we leave the rest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then let your heart do. If you have connection here, everything else will go smooth, just like he said. Fish need water, you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than food and anything. And what gets you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not just a simple. We talked about dhikr before. We didn't say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. We told you thinking is dhikr. We told you working is dhikr. We told you anything you do, reminding you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or reminding people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is dhikr. So this is not just limited to subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanallah al-azim. It is your way of life, the way you look, the way you smile, the way you talk, the way you think. It's all dhikr. Once you make your life like that, connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your hand automatically would come out and pull the money and give. Your tongue will automatically speak and enjoy good and forbid evil. Your feet will automatically come to the masjid. Your mind will automatically be reflecting on the day of judgment. and your ears will automatically be listening and attracted to the Quran, not the music. That is what dhikr, and that is what reminds remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does to you. It makes your limbs serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Help us do that, inshallah. Bring your children to ISI, and if you don't have children at ISI, what do you do? Make dua for those at ISI and support them. Jazakumullah khairan. Don't forget, this listener is back. Sheikh Yasser is coming here at 6 p.m., 6 to 8. He's going to do parenting. So you and your children bring your parents, and parents bring your children. Come for a workshop, and inshallah, you see the better connection between the parents and their children. School can do some work. Parents have to step in and do more work together, inshallah.